If you're currently using Microsoft 365 or Office 365 at work or at school, now for the first time, you'll be able to experience Copilot right within the context of your work inside of Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Outlook, and OneNote, all at no extra cost, and you don't need a Copilot add-on license. Importantly, you can use it with OpenAI's GPT-5 model, the same AI that powers ChatGPT, without copying, pasting, or uploading your files outside of your protected work apps. And today, I'll walk you through how you can leverage these in-app experiences along with the controls available for IT. Everything I'll show you today, by the way, works in both the desktop and web apps. I'm going to start with Copilot and Outlook. As you can see, I have a full inbox after being away for a few days. And now, instead of working through this long email thread to figure out what it's all about and what I need to take action on, I can just ask Copilot, please draft a recap of this email thread for me to share it with my launch team. And Copilot analyzes the open thread and it generates a reply with a clear summary of major updates since I've been away. And it looks like the heart rate detection feature has been enhanced and is launching ahead of schedule. As a result, the leadership meeting has been moved up. And I can see that my action item is to update our slides to reflect the new feature and the revised positioning ahead of my presentation. I'm going to start in Word to begin generating the updates that I'll need for my presentation. So here I've got a technical specifications document open for Zava Core Fiber. I need to add to it for our meeting. Instead of switching apps or uploading files, I just open up Copilot Chat on the right side pane and it understands the context of my open document. I can let Copilot know that I prefer generated content to be concise, and Copilot will take this into account as it generates content. Now I can ask Copilot, write an executive summary in a bulleted list, and Copilot authors the summary. I just need to click on this copy icon to copy it, then I can paste it under the executive summary heading in my document, and now my technical spec is complete. So that was Word. Now let's move on to Excel to create a data visualization that I'll incorporate also into my presentation. So here I've got a spreadsheet that's full of satisfaction and performance metrics for our new product. Now in Copilot Chat, I can ask, generate a bar chart showing the overall satisfaction scores across regions, use different colors for each bar. And I didn't need to tell Copilot which columns to use or which ones to calculate the insights from in the spreadsheet. It knows what to do. And there's my bar chart with satisfaction scores across north, south, east, west, and central regions. It's exactly what I asked for without having to leave Excel. So now that I have what I need to update my presentation, I'm going to move over to Copilot Chat in PowerPoint. This is my deck for Zava Core Smart Fiber, and I want to make a few updates to it based on the email thread from before and what we just did in Word and Excel. And I want to go back to those Copilot Chats. So this time in the Copilot pane, I'll open up the Ellipse menu. And from here, I can view all my recent Copilot Chats. So I'm going to choose the one from a moment ago. Please remember that I prefer generated content in Copilot Chat to be concise. And down within that chat session, you can see I have my bullet list of executive summary. And now I'm going to copy that and put that in the new features overview. And I'll keep going. I'll return back to the previous chat. This time the one from Excel with a bar chart that was based on our open Excel file, because I want to add that to my PowerPoint as well. So I'll grab that chart and I'll place it on the left side of this slide. And now it's looking how I want it to. I'm going to move on to slide 5 because I want to generate a new image for the slide. So I'll go back into Copilot and I'll select new chat. Now I'll ask Copilot to create a high-tech image of an ECG sensor. And that takes a moment or so to generate, but there's my new image. Once it's finished, I can add that to my slide. Now I want to make sure that my presentation includes answers to the questions that we think that our audience will have. And we've prepared a few documents with that information recently. So from Copilot Chat, I'll just start writing, suggest some Q&As for this presentation, then I'll reference the documents I want. To do that, I just need to type the forward slash, and that then shows me all my recent documents. I'm going to choose our spec doc, and then I'll send my prompt, and Copilot then generates a nice list of questions and answers, and I'm ready for my presentation. And if you're in IT and want to ensure that your company data stays protected with the policies and controls that you've already put in place, the good news is that Copilot Chat has enterprise-grade protections like the add-on Microsoft 365 Copilot license. You can manage everything that you just saw in the apps using the Copilot control system, including enforceable data loss prevention and information protection policies from Microsoft Purview. And Copilot Chat is pinned by default, so it becomes discoverable throughout the different app experiences. And you can also view Copilot usage in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center, as well as deeper insights in the Copilot dashboard. Being able to use Copilot directly from your apps as you work not only saves you time, but also keeps you in your flow. And with the premium experience available with the Microsoft 365 Copilot license, your productivity gets even better, and you can use Copilot inside a broader set of Microsoft 365 apps. So a few of the standout capabilities include intelligent work data retrieval, where it pulls from the files in your OneDrive, your shared documents, emails, meetings, conversations, and more, automatically without you needing to reference them. In other words, it works with all the work data that you have permissions to access in the Microsoft Graph and reasons over it to generate responses. And second is meeting facilitation. So if you're using Microsoft Teams, Microsoft 365 Copilot works during meetings to facilitate discussions or catch you up on what you might have missed, take detailed notes with action items, and more. And third is specialized agents, where you can create and use agents with your data in Microsoft 365 and get access to pre-built agents from Microsoft with advanced reasoning. The new included experiences that I showed today are a great way for everyone to start using Copilot Chat directly in Microsoft 365 apps. Try it today by clicking the Copilot button in the app ribbon to get started. Subscribe to Microsoft Mechanics for the latest AI tech, and thanks so much for watching.